Even with the best camera, our depth of field may not turn out exactly how we want, and we're here to fix that. Howdy everyone, hope you're doing well. In this short video, we're gonna show you how to add a blurred background to your existing photograph, and we're gonna be going over two methods today. So you can use this editing trick on portraits as well as architecture or close-ups like flowers. I'm going to start with this portrait right here. Now I want my subject to be the only sharp and in focus thing, and then I want the wall to be blurred. And so I'm going to use what's called a tilt shift effect. The tilt shift effect is found in the editor module under the effects tools. And you can also select it using the keyboard shortcut shift and F. In the last part of the photo composite series, we already showed you how to use and take advantage of the tilt shift effect. And you can find a link to that video right here somewhere. Anyways, it can bear repeating though. I add the effect to the photo and use the guidelines to adjust which area I want to be sharp and which area I want to be blurred. Now the center of the effect is gonna be sharp. And so I can use the guidelines to set the area around the center that I want to be blurred. Now we're gonna use the blur slider right here to adjust the intensity of the blur. And of course it's up to you how much blur you want. Now personally, I don't want any reflections in the photo, but if we play around with it, we can see what it's like having reflections in the photos and what it does. Now you can see reflections create an almost sort of bokeh effect. And this may be something you want, maybe you don't, but for my taste and my preference, I don't want it here. And so I'm going to actually disable reflections. Now I pull down brightening all the way to zero because I don't want this photo to be any brighter. Now the tilt shift effect also is going to affect the saturation of our image. And I'm going to lower it because I don't want my photo to be any more saturated and sort of have those sort of fake over bright colors that is just no good. All right, and we're done. Now let's check out a second method for blurring the background. This time let's blur the background behind this statue. And I'm going to use the Gaussian blur and the selection tools. First, let's open the selection tools and select the statue as well as the column. Now I'm going to invert the selection later because selecting only the background would be a lot more complex. Now you'll be able to find out which tool is going to be best suited to your personal taste and depending on what you're selecting in the selection tools, and I'll post a link somewhere right here. But today we're going to be using the magnetic lasso. Once I have my object selected, I'm gonna choose Invert Selection, which of course selects the background instead of the statue. Now we're gonna duplicate the original layer so that we always have a backup. Next, I'm gonna just click Adjustments and then choose Blur. And I have Gaussian selected for the type, and let's check the Blur Only Select area. And let's also select High Quality so that the blur doesn't actually affect our sculpture. And I think the blur strength right here around 19 is gonna be best for what we want. All right, that's it. Piece of cake, right? That's it for me in this video. Hope it was useful. Let us know what you think below. Give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video. Ciao.